participate in the discussion of supplementary budget demands for grants 2018 and 19. At the very outset, on behalf of my Chief Minister Nana Chandrababu Naidu Garu and 5 crore people of Andhra Pradesh, I express my total disappointment, disagreement and anguish over the statement made by the Honorable Prime Minister during the reply on the motion of no confidence in the Council of Ministers moved by our TDP party, justifying his government's refusal to accord special category status to the state of Andhra Pradesh. We did not accept such irresponsible, irrational answer from him on the issue of special category status. We are totally anguished and upset over the statement and denial of special category status attributing to the recommendations of the 14th Finance Commission. Not only is this claim a belt and lie, but a true example of dishonesty you are showing towards the state of Andhra Pradesh and its 5 crore people. In this contest, I would like to once again draw the attention of this august house and this government, the observation of Sri Vaivi Reddy Garu, the chairman of the 14th Finance Commission, on 8th January 2018, that the Finance Commission has nothing to do with recommending or not recommending any special category status to any state. Further, Sri M. Govindarao Garu, a member of the 14th Finance Commission, has also clarified in this issue. In view of the denial of this SCS to AP and also misleading of this august house by the Honorable Prime Minister by attributing recommendations of 14th Finance Commission and also non-implementation of major assurances made in the APR Act 2014, I would therefore demand the Union Government to immediately constitute a joint parliamentary committee with a mandate of 2 months to look into the recommendations of the 14th Finance Commission and also to implement the assurances of the then Prime Minister in Rajya Sabha on 20th February 2014 on the issue of conferring the special status category to Andhra Pradesh. I regret to mention here, sir, that 4 years down the line, this government did not bother to implement any of the major assurances made in the APR Act 2014, and this is the last chance for this Union government to allocate sufficient funds in the supplementary budget. We are at a loss to understand when the people of Andhra Pradesh, the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh and several leaders cutting across the political parties at both the state and center have been demanding to fulfill the assurances made in the AP Reorganization Act 2014. Especially on the issue of special category status, why the NDA government headed by the Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji is showing total indifference to the state and its people. The Prime Minister always speaks about the cooperation of federalism, but in reality it is not seen in the understand what it really means. Power comes and goes, but the will of the people of the state and the country are the paramount consideration. Do we need to remind this NDA government that Andhra Pradesh is a part and parcel of this country? Further, most of the revenue to the center comes from our southern states. We demand a complete answer from the Union government once again as to why the request of the government of AP on special category status has not been considered and the reasons for a denial of the special category status to Andhra Pradesh. In this contest, I would like to draw the attention of this august house towards the reply furnished by the Ministry of Finance in response to the unstated question number 567 dated 28th July 2018 raised by me, which clearly shows discrimination, bias on the funds released under AP Reorganization Act 2014 regarding capital city, Polavaram irrigation project and other provisions of the act and institutions covered under schedule. As per the Ministry of Finance reply, the funds released by the Union government for the last 4 years, that is from 2014-15 to 2018-19, shows as under. For resources gap, 3,979.50 crores. Assistance for capital city for development of essential infrastructure is 1,500 crores. For drainage scheme at Vijayawada and Guntur cities, 1,000 crores. Funds released under backward districts of state covering Rayalaseema and North Coastal region is 1,050 crores. Construction of Polavaram project, 6,764 crores. Funds released at NXEA is total rupees 14,294.20 crores only. Similarly, for the funds released during the last 4 years, which has been mentioned in Annexe B, for establishment of AIIMS, rupees 233.88 crores, for IIT, 98.20 crores, for IIIT, 20.10 crores, for NIT, rupees 60 crores, for IIM, 49.96 crores, for IISER, 64 crores, for Agriculture University, 135 crores, and Indian Institute of Petroleum and Energy, 33 crores. It means the funds released under Annexe B is totally 694.14 crores. If we calculate Annexe B and Annexe A, the total funds released by the Union Government towards the Government of Andhra Pradesh for the last 4 years, it is around 14,988.34 crores. It shows that the government is not serious in honoring the assurance made by the AP Reaction Act 2014. The amount of rupees 14,988.34 crores so far released is not at all adequate for meeting the developmental schemes of the Union Government to fully support along with the backward states of our country by allotting sufficient funds in the supplementary budget. But to our utter dismay, this NDA government is boasting themselves from the roof of top, saying that they had released more funds to the government of Andhra Pradesh than any previous governments. How can you claim that you had released more funds as against the factual position of the ground reality? Why such a discrimination is releasing funds? Are we not part and parcel of this country? If you look at the answers given by the Ministry of Finance and the also Ministry of Home Affairs and other ministries on the issue of funds released, I am sure it will take another 20 to 30 years time to complete all the educational premier institutions, construction of new capital city, Rajbhavan, High Court, and etc. The Prime Minister, during his reply on motion of no confidence, had said that AP has not bifurcated by the then UPA government in a scientific manner. That was also one of the reasons as to why the people of Andhra Pradesh gave you mandate. You are now sitting at the helm of the affairs. Instead of digging up the past, you should at least render justice to us and address the issue of the people of Andhra Pradesh. Special category status to Andhra Pradesh and fulfill all promises contained in the AP Reorganization Act 2014 regarding establishment of new railway zone at Vizag, new steel plant at Kodapastra district, new port at Digirajapatnam, increasing the assembly seats to AP Legislative Assembly, Giriya University, metro projects at Vijayawada and Visakhapatnam, and Vizag Chennai Industrial Corridor. As per the assurance of the then Honorable Minister on the floor of the Rajya Sabha on 20th February 2014, the resource gap in the successor state of the Andhra Pradesh from first year, especially during the period between the appointed day and the acceptance of the 14th Finance Commission recommendations by the Government of India, has to be compensated in the regular union budget for the year 2014 and 15. Last bit, sir. Revenue deficit for the year 2014-15 was arrived at rupees 16,078.76 crores by accountant general. But till day, only 3,979.50 crores has been released. I therefore request the Union Government to release the entire balance amount in the supplementary demand for grants. Having said that, the AP Government is reeling under severe revenue deficit. Section 94, Clause 4 of the AP Reorganization Act 2014 stipulates for financial assistance for new capital, for building of secretariat, the High Court, sir, last page, sir, Rajbhavan, etc., where the total cost of the capital building is close to 50,000 crores. However, the Government of India has so far released 2,500 crores. That includes 1,000 crores for the development of underground drainage in Vijayawada and Guntur municipal corporations. Hence, I urge upon the government to allocate adequate funds to the tune of 25,000 crores in the supplementary budget for the construction of new capital city at Amaravati, Secretariat, how High Court funds for polo irrigation project. Schedule 13 of this APR Act 2014 says, sir, last minute, sir, last, sir, very few, last page. Schedule 13 of the APR Act 2014 says that establishment of the educational primary institutions out of 11 institutions mentioned in the Schedule 13, 9 have been sanctioned so far. The government of India is yet to establish tribal university in Vijayanagaram district. For the 9 sanctioned institutions, the government of AP has provided nearly 2,900 acres of valuable land at an estimated value of 11,600 crores. For the further, the Andhra Pradesh government had released an amount of 130 crores for the construction of compound walls to protect the land that has been allotted to the said 9 institutions. Against the estimated project cost of 11,693 crores, the government...
Vinod Kumar.
Sir.
Thank you.